Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Han as a gemologist. Welcome to my channel. If you subscribe and alarm, you can get the best information about gemstones and jewelry. Let's look at the list of topics I'm gonna teach everyone from basic to advanced course step by step. Today's topic is gemstones UV visible spectra for identification. Today, let's find out how to identify gemstones. Typically, we can identify the color gemstones by testing the following. Refractive index, specific gravity, inclusion, fluorescence, and pleochroism. Sometimes we need more detailed testing. For confirmation as follows, natural or synthetic, heat treatment and beryllium diffusion, heat and lead glass treatments, electron beam radiation, and certain gemstones. At this time, you can investigate these gemstones by advanced machines, such as UV visible spectrometer, FDIR, X-ray diffraction, X-ray fluorescence spectrometer. Today, I'm gonna talk about UV visible spectroscopy. What is the UV visible spectroscopy? UV visible spectroscopy is a technique based on the absorption of light by a unknown sample. Let's look at how this device works. Optical spectroscopy is based on the interaction of light with substance. If light is shining onto an object, they will be absorbed by the object. For example, red light is reflected by the red apple, whereas green light is reflected by the green apple. All other colors are absorbed. The reflected light is seen by the eyes. The energy of light vibrated periodically between a minimum and a maximum like a wave. The distance of the electromagnetic wave is defined as the wavelength. The energy increases with decreasing wavelengths. Each color has a particular wavelength. For example, green light has a wavelength 500 to 565 nanometer, whereas red has 625 to 740 nanometer. The sum of all wavelengths is called a spectrum. The spectrum of visible light ranges from 400 to 780 nanometer approximately. According to the substance, light is partially absorbed. As the remaining light, the transmitted light is recorded as a function of wavelengths by providing the sample UV visible spectrum. As a result, the spectrum can be used to identify gemstones. UV visible spectrophotometer measures the intensity of light passing through a gemstone and compares it to the intensity of the light passed without gemstone. The main components of this tool are a light source, a sample holder, a dispersive device, and a detector. Now, let's apply UV visible spectroscopy to the gemstone's case. Generally, gemstones have transition metals in the crystal lattice, especially in the octahedral site. If the light illuminates to the gemstones, electrons of the transition metals will be excited as absorbed the light. This energy is different depending on gemstones, respectively. As you look at the UV visible spectrum of blue sapphire, it shows absorption band near 580 nanometer. Therefore, as the complementary color, it will be reflected the blue. In other words, when the light illuminates to the blue sapphire, ferrothion and titanium ion will interact with each other as follows. Ferrothion plus titanium 4-valent cation is perigion plus titanium 3-valent cation. Their energy gap is 2.11 electron volts. As a result, the absorption occurs near 580 nanometer. In case of emerald, you can see two strong absorption bands near 430 and 615 nanometer. These are violet and yellow-red absorptions. These two absorptions are responsible for strong blue-green transmission. This UV visible spectrum is caused by chromium trivalent cation. If light illuminates to the emerald, chromium ion absorbs the light and will be excited. So, this energy will result in green. Okay, rest of the quiz. Question. What technique is UV visible spectroscopy based on? Answer. It is based on the absorption of light. Thank you for watching my video. If this lecture is useful to you, please subscribe and share with your friends. Also, if you watch my other videos, you can get more information about gemstones. See you next video. Have a great day.